Hi, and in today's tutorial, I'm going to show you how to create this really quick and simple bake sale poster in Word. So the first thing we're going to do is to get our graphics. And for this, we're just going to pop onto the internet. This is all perfectly free, and go to the website called pixabay.com. In the end of the search bar, here's a little arrow. If you click on that, go down to vectors, and then in the search bar, just type in cake, press enter. So here you'll see you have a lot of variety of different image options, and you can just download these for free. You may need to put in your email, but apart from that, you can download them for free. I'm going to select this one here, and just ensure that when your image is displayed, you have this checkable background. This means that when you import it or insert it into Word, the background will be transparent. So then just click on free download. I'll choose the biggest file and click download. Back into Word, go to Insert, Picture, click on the drop down, select Picture from File, go to your downloads, and I'll just click on the image we've downloaded and click Insert. When your image is inserted into Word, you won't be able to move it around, so select it, right click, go down to Wrap Text, and select In Front of Text. Now, you can use all of these images if you want to, but I'm only going to use this cake, and you can split up this image as much as you like. Don't forget to duplicate it though if you want to use more than one element, because we're going to crop it. So select the image, go to picture format, go to crop and click. You have these black markers around the outside, and all you need to do is hover over one of them and pull in the crop to just cut out what we don't need. So I'm just going to use this cake in the middle. Make that crop as small as possible. There we go, and just press enter. And then we've just cropped out the rest of the image and we're just left with this cake. So I'm going to duplicate this, and I find the easiest way to do this is just to hit your Alt or Option key whilst you've selected the image. Click on Alt or Image and just duplicate, click and drag. Again, select this image, hold down the Alt or Option key, click and drag. Then I'm going to make sure that these are equally spaced. So I'm going to select the first one, hold down my Command or Control key and click on the remainder. Go to Picture Format, go along to Align, click on the drop down and go down to Distribute Horizontally. And you'll see now they're equally spaced, but they're not lined up. So again, go to the Alignment tool, select Align to Top. Now they're all equally spaced, we can go to Group, click on the drop down and select Group, back to the Alignment tool, and then select Align to Center, and then they're all perfectly lined up in the middle of your poster. Now go to Insert, go to Word Art and click. You can choose any of these that you want, but I'm going to choose this one here, and then all I'm going to do is enter my text, bake, deselect it, then reselect it so we can go make some adjustments. Go to the Home tab. I'm going to go to the fonts and select Cooper. I'm going to increase my font size. And then I'm going to change the color. So go to font color, click on the drop down. You've got lots of colors to choose from. And you can also go to more colors and match your colors. Now, the easy option is the eyedropper tool. Select this tool here and you can go over to your cakes and select from these colors here. This will tie in and make your image and poster a bit more cohesive. Now, I know for lots of people, the eyedropper tool doesn't exist. So what you can do is you can use this little cursor here and move it around your color wheel and try and match that top color. We can see it's pink, but it's got more red in it than it has pink. So you go towards the reddy pink. If you move it closer to the middle, it's brighter. And if you move it to the edge, it's more saturated. So move it around and find the color that matches best. So I'm just going to use my eyedropper tool and then click OK. And on this particular text, if we just zoom in, you can see we've got a shadow line here. To access that shadow line, go to Shape Format. Go along to Format Pane. You'll see this menu here. So make sure you're on Text Options and not Shape. Shape refers to the actual box that the text is in. Go to Text Options, go to the middle tab here and go down to Shadow. And you'll see by the color that you're on the right menu, because obviously that color is blue and our shadow is also blue. Now, once again, we can match these colors to this blue here. So click on color, go down to more colors. Again, you can use the eyedropper tool, or you can simply use the cursor in the middle and click OK. Go back up and you'll see that that shadow now matches. I'm just going to take that blur here down to zero because I want it to be nice and sharp. Let's zoom back out. And then all we need to do is duplicate this text box by again selecting it, hold down your Alt or Option key, click and drag. I'm going to make this text a little bigger, so make sure your cursor's not inside. If your cursor's inside, you won't be able to make those adjustments. You can click across the text, click and drag, and then make adjustments, but it's just easier if you just select the text box without the cursor being inside. Go to the Home tab, and I'm going to increase the size of this text to about there. And then this one, I'm going to change the text, so you do need to double click inside. I'm going to select Command or Control A to select all of the text, and then just type in sale. And then we can use this text box again, duplicate it, holding down that Alt or Option key. And then I'm going to reduce the text using the Decrease Font Size tool here. And then just click inside and I'll enter some more text. And again, let's duplicate this. And again, select the text. There we go. Now, we can move all of this text around roughly where we want it. If we zoom out, it gives us a better idea where we want all of the text. Let's move those cakes down a little bit. I'm just going to decrease the size of this font here. So again, using that Decrease Font Size tool. Perfect. Now let's align everything. So let's pull those two down. Select them all by holding down the Command or Control key and just clicking on all of those elements. Go to Shape Format, Align, Align to Center. Now what this means is each one of these text boxes is now lined up together, but it's not lined up to the middle of your page. So go to Group, click on the drop down and select Group, and now go to Align, Align to Center. So it's aligning that whole group of text to the middle of your page. If you want to make changes, it's fine. Just go back up to Group and select Ungroup, and then you can make those relevant changes. So a little bit of graphics on the outside. We're going to go up to the Insert tab here. Go to Shapes, click on the drop down, select the circle. Now with the circle, you need to hold down the Shift key when you click and drag to ensure it's a perfect circle. Otherwise, you'll find it's an oval. So just make sure it's a circle. And then again, select it. This will have an outline on it. So I'm going to go to Shape Format, go to Shape Outline, click on the drop down and select No Outline. And again, Shape Fill, and you can select from your recent colors that you've chosen, so you don't have to go and use that eyedropper tool again. There we go. And then duplicate again. So holding down the Alt key, we're going to duplicate it and then duplicate it again. Now we're going to make sure that we've put them all on the page. Again, holding down that Command or Control key, select them all, go up to Align. We'll distribute them horizontally so they're all equally spaced. Then we'll align them to the bottom, make sure they're all lined up. Then we can group them, and then we can move this round as we choose. So let's move it down to there. We're going to duplicate this and just change the color. So again, holding down that Alt or Option key to duplicate it. Deselect it because we had both of them selected. Let's reselect this one, go to Group and Ungroup. Whilst they're all selected, just go to Shape Fill and select another color, such as pink. Then you can go back to Group and select Group. And then we can actually align them to the center again as well. Make sure they're all perfectly lined up. Align to center. There we go. Now for me, the bake sale is a bit too close, so let's just move that down. I can use my arrow keys for that. There we go. Perfect. So it's just a really quick and simple poster. You can add lots of graphics to it if you want to. And of course, you can add more images. So I hope that's helped you today. If it has, please like and subscribe and have a great day.